Karan, we're all obviously gathered here, and for everybody's knowledge, gathered here to launch your first and hopefully only jewelry brand. Yeah. So, you know, I'm going to ask you this question on behalf of every working person out there. Actor, director, writer, producer, host, judge. I'm almost breathless right now. How do you do it? Are you going to leave any work for us?
My first answer is, do we really need this mic in this room? I think we might need it for the cameras. Okay. Because I'm finding it really funny to speak on this mic in this room. No, it's all great. It's all perks of the job. Mm-hmm. My core and primary profession is really filmmaking, and that's my big passion. Everything is a derivative of that. And it's an extension of my personality and the job that I do, and I love it. So yeah, multitasking is my thing. And being the jack of all trades and perhaps the master of none, my thing as well.
Well, no, Karan, we beg to differ. Master of all is what we like to call you. So, you know, here you are doing something, and of late we've seen your fashion choices. They've been absolutely fabulous. Everybody follows you. Apart from your movies, they also, you know, you're the only director who's followed for his fashion choices. And now jewelry. What about Karan Johar has been brought into Tiani as a brand?
Initially, when Shravan came and met me, the whole idea was, of course, to collaborate on something that was, you know, larger than life as a collection, you know, more like wedding and trousseau and, you know, big event jewelry, you know, the ones that, you know, like are ornate and special and specific and really beautiful. I mean, everybody knows that from the Satyani group, the jewelry is exceptional. Tiani, which is the extension of the brand and a glorious extension, if I might add, is actually something that we discussed and decided to make it much more fashion forward and fashion fast. You know, something that, you know, everybody can wear. So to take polki jewelry and give it a totally different avatar, you know, to try and make it more like when you go to work and you just go for a casual lunch, dinner, just get out of your house and you spring on this jewelry. I wanted to make a brand that was more accepted, more accessible, affable to you as a personality and not daunting and overwhelming, because jewelry sometimes is always over the top and associated with big events and big milestone celebrations. But I don't think that that should be the case. You know, polki is something that is traveled, you know, for Miras. It's from the Mughal era onwards, you know, we've seen the advent of this amazing jewelry and what it's eventually become even internationally on red carpets and, you know, even casual day-to-day events has taken a totally different form. So Shravan and I kind of worked out a way that we would produce this jewelry, go online with it and make it completely fashion fast, fashion forward and completely accessible to all ages, all stages, all rages. Everyone knows that you're wearing, of course you're still looking more ornate because you always make jewelry look so stunning and you are so gorgeous wherever you go.
Wow, okay. I think before he comes up with a third compliment, which is not going to be
which is going to be on what you're wearing, I love it.
We will get to that. We have a section dedicated to my choices in fashion as well in this chat. But you know, Karan, you were speaking about India and associations with jewelry, and then if you go back, you know, far into history, the minute you think about jewelry, you always think of this large grand event like you did mention right now. And in your life, of course, everything is a grand event, even if it's making chai. But a lot of you don't know, but it takes six people to make Karan Johar's chai. He of course doesn't know how to make his own, but Karan, no, we're talking about jewelry and not his cup of tea. Everything is his cup of tea.
It's always a cup of coffee, it's never tea.
Yes, always a cup of coffee, I must, note to self. But you know, Karan, we've spoken about polki, we've spoken about the fact that you met, you know, everyone from the brand of Satyani, and then they came to you and they kind of, you know, said that we want to launch a jewelry brand with you. What did you change? Who is the Tiani woman? What does she wear to work on a daily basis? Describe that woman who's going to wear this brand to us.
So the woman actually is pretty much, I think, the woman of today. You know, I think confident, assured, you know, has her eye on her ambition and her achievement and is not like all about like just showing her, you know, it's not all about just projecting beauty and fashion and being in your face. I think the woman of today is confident, she's solid, she has an achievement behind her, she has a path ahead that she needs to go there, and I wish men had the same goals that women do, really. But I think she's solid and she's confident, and so is the jewelry. It really goes with, it's it's I believe that of men and women, you know, sometimes we tend to kind of go away from the zone of fashion because we're apologetic about it, because we always feel like fashion is just for certain people because it seems alien. But I don't think you should accept it and open it with arms, because jewelry is something that is part of our culture, is part of our heritage. When you make it accessible and make it today and make it wearable, I think that's the whole intent, Ityani, is to make sure that when you leave the house and you have a solid goal in life, it's not that you should be apologetic about looking pretty and putting on a pair of beautiful earrings or having something around your hand. That could actually just kind of enlighten you or might kind of heighten your confidence level in the morning when you set out. So I think the woman of today is all those qualities that I mentioned and much more. And the jewelry is actually coinciding and collaborating with that imagery.
You know, it's so interesting that you said, I mean, of course, the things that you said about the woman and the Tiani woman, it's interesting, and you brought about this one little bit about men who shouldn't be apologetic. If you were to go ahead, which I know you will go ahead and talk more about the brand will expand. Any ideas about jewelry for men?
Totally. I mean, that's the next step forward, because I think, like, if you see the fashion scenario, men are, there is what we call the word androgynous, you know, which is used when, you know, men are more fashionable and more tilted to fashion choices. And, you know, when you use loosely, words are thrown around like, oh, he's metrosexual and he's androgynous and things like that. None of that really makes sense. You're either interested in the zone of fashion, which is a $1 billion industry, and you want to wear a ring, you want to wear a bracelet, you want to wear a chain because you think it's upping your game, then why not? Go ahead and do it. Don't worry and feel like, oh, men don't wear jewelry. It's like ridiculous. It's such a stupid cliche. I mean, I don't think we should go down that path of even believing those statements or imbibing them or emulating them in your day-to-day life. I think if you want to wear a ring that is not religious, that is perhaps fashionable, you want a bracelet that your grandmother didn't give you, you know, that you actually bought from a counter because it looks kind of hip and cool. You want to wear a chain that is, again, not making some kind of a family statement. It's fine. Go ahead and do it. Unabashedly, unapologetically, in your face fashionable is not a bad thing. And you've got to realize that, you know, it is who you are. It's an extension of your personality. So if you're a man, woman, and no matter what the differentiation is, why do we generalize things like this? So when I say that Shravan and I are working on stage two, we will. There will be jewelry for men, but it'll be, of course, customized to their requirements and their needs. And I hope that there are many men out there who will change their way of thinking eventually. But for now, we're focusing on the fashion fast, fashion forward jewelry of the moment and day.
Yeah, so that's exactly why it's also the Tiani woman who's going to go out there and for a change buy jewelry for men. Otherwise, it's always the other way around.
Well, I hope they do. I hope everyone just buys the jewelry that we create.
I promise you, Karan, the pre-orders have already started.
From you, I hope.
Yes, from me, very much from me. No, so, you know, Karan, because, you know, you're so synonymous with cinema. You're literally the first face of cinema. And of course, we will not let you go without answering this question. If you were to pick one woman who describes, or one famous actress who actually describes all the qualities or embodies all the qualities of the Tiani woman, who do you think, which is the first name that actually comes to your mind?
I mean, there's so many women I respect and adore in the fraternity. I mean, you know, when you think of big jewelry and beautiful Indian traditional jewelry, you think of Rekha. You know, you think of that.
Yes.
When you think of beautiful, stunning diamonds and glory, you think of Aishwarya Rai. When you think of fashionable jewelry, you think of Sonam Kapoor. When you think of just the girl next door, you think of Alia Bhatt, because she has that. So there are so many of these women that I've really enjoyed watching on celluloid, and I continue to admire their fashion choices, their work choices, their professional achievements. I don't think you should categorize actresses in being, because I think women are so much more than just their achievement. They're not only procreators, but they're also wonderful, wonderful forces that you have to reckon with, especially
Absolutely.
The men of the world. They don't know what's hit them half the time, because the women are going to take over. And they're not only their fashion choices, but their individualistic nature and their strength in general.
I totally agree with you, Karan. You know, but we were talking about this a little while ago, and I promised you we're going to come back. What do you think of my look? I've got a lot of your designed jewelry on.
Oh, the jewelry looks stunning.
Okay, and the rest of it.
The jewelry looks stunning, yeah.
Okay, he hasn't paid me a compliment. I tried.
No.
Really
I just told her, I said, oh God, you're looking like one of those very high society women who have come to a lunch, you know, with the handbag in place. And I said, that's wonderful. I love your lunch look.
Oh, that's
lady of leisure. That's what you're looking like.
That's a bit worrying. I don't remember the last time I had a lunch with jewelry on, but from now on I will, because
but that's the whole idea. That's what we're trying to say. That of course you don't have to wear something so dramatic. You chose this. We would have given you something more subtle, perhaps. But I'm just saying that, you know, actually when you step out of your domain and you go out of your workspace and into your workspace from your home to the, you can just spring on. The range is quite fantastic, actually. You know, you have jewelry that ranges from 10,000 rupees onwards. It's not daunting. When you go into jewelry and you have daunting kind of feelings about price range, Tiani at Tiani.com, it's not the case.
What can I get for 10,000 rupees?
You can get
Tiani?
A beautiful pair of earrings.
You can get
a lovely bracelet. You can get a beautiful ring. You can get so much.
That's
not all three, one of them.
No, that's pretty amazing for you know, because it's amazing for someone like you to actually, the minute we think about you, we don't think high street, we think high end. And this is literally the high street of Polki, because, you know, it's affordable jewelry for each and every one. Any particular piece of jewelry which is your most favorite, which is... Imagine if I came to you and I said, Karan, I have very little budget, and you know I always say that to you, I have very little money to buy this, advise me. The last time Karan advised me, he was helping me buy a handbag, and he was like, okay, and what's your budget? The one he chose, let me tell you all, I sent him pictures on my WhatsApp, and the one he chose was by far the most expensive, and then I gave him my budget, and he's like, go away, you're so last season. So if I give you my limited budget at Tiani, what would you get?
No, there's so much, like I told you, there are beautiful earrings, all the earrings are stunning. In fact, you know, and I believe that I have a great fascination for just earrings. You know, I think they can really complete a look in the best possible way. Whether it's a corporate suit, you know, or a beautiful salwar kameez, a simple salwar kameez, or it's just a trousers and a shirt, I think this earrings can just pick up an entire outfit and just make you feel so much more glorious. So there are so many earrings that I love at of the collection. I've seen all of them and they're stunning. And I think more than anything else, like you brought up the point, that the association with me is that kind of certain kind of lifestyle, and that's a perception I've been trying to change for years. There's nothing I can do.
We can do it right now if you want to change. No, so anything I'm just you'd like to say.
No, I don't want to change what is perceived, because perception
and also
is
what's true.
Perception is reality. But the whole idea was to make sure that our brand traveled far and wide. And, you know, it made it accessible to millions of women across the world. That, you know, the fact that they kind of are not, like, worried and daunted by the fact that this jewelry is going to be overwhelming, either look-wise or price-wise, it is the way forward for online shopping. When you go online, you expect to get the best quality and also the best price. And I think that's what we do at Tiani.
And it is. I mean, congratulations, Karan, because this is the world's largest online Polki store.
Yeah.
And I know you're a big...
And let me tell you a bit about Polki. It's important to know that Polki sounds exceptionally traditional, but it's the hippest thing to wear. And I think that's the kind of the blurred line that we're trying to cross.
No, and I think you've done really well, because I was seeing pictures from Paris Fashion Week and stuff, and I think this is the same stone that they're using.
Yeah.
And, you know, with Tiani.com, has it got something to do with you? Because you're a big online shopper. You don't believe in a touch and feel before buying something. If you like something, you pick it up. Has it got something to do with you, or is it because the world is flat and nobody should wait for the next collection for another 6 hours and then just buy everything?
You know, in our day-to-day madness of our existence, you know, just making the time to go to a shop and really shopping, those are luxuries that some of us don't have. We all have work to do. We have deadlines to meet. We're running around half the time. Online shopping is my guilty pleasure, and it's my practical way forward. So there's two things. It's like I'm obsessed by online shopping.
All right, quick question. How many hours in a day do you shop online? At what point in your day do you shop online?
Well, I spend more time shopping online than I am on Instagram and Twitter put together. So that would mean a lot of time online. It's, you know, in between meetings, sometimes when I'm bored, nobody realizes I'm actually looking at like an online shopping site. And I'm just checking an email. And actually, I'm just seeing the new collections come up. I've got like I've got a notification, and I'm on it, and I'm like, okay, I have to reply to this. And that means I have to buy it.
Yeah. All right. McQueen's big bag has just arrived while he's with the... I'm not going to name who.
Like, you know, the thing is, I am not apologetic about being a crazy shopper. Like, I don't want to be apologetic about it. I own it. I love it. I am who I am. And I really love the fact that I'm crazy in this department. Like, I told my CEO, and I said, I don't have any vices. He said, I suppose you should acquire a new vice, because it'll be way cheaper than what your vice is vis-a-vis shopping. But it's just the thing I am. Like, I'm half Sindhi. It comes with the territory. We shop.
Wow. Have you ever had this moment where you shopped, and then been like, oh my God, what have I done? And now I need to go into this meeting, close this deal just because I've shopped a lot.
I don't feel guilt about buying things for myself.
Never.
No.
We're not gonna ask you what the highest.
I feel guilty when I let go of a thing, you know, that I haven't been able to get in my size. That gives me deep amounts of guilt.
Don't we all want your life?
No, you don't want my life. You actually just want to live in. The thing is, I work really hard. I work very hard on the things I do. And I don't know whatever the outcome is for everyone to judge later. But I'm putting in a lot of hours. This is my hobby. People like meditate. People chant. I shop.
That's amazing. And that's why we know that tiani.com is not going to be wrong in any way.
Because no, because it's an extension of, it's totally, yes. It's a piece of my heart.
Yes, it really is.
You don't understand.
Is.
When Shravan came and pitched online shopping and made it jewel based, and I was like, I'm sold. You got me at hello.
So those are the keywords. Online shopping and Tiani are the keywords for today. Right. But Karan, it's been amazing talking to you.
More fantastic talking to you, Neha.
Oh, well, thank you.
I mean, you're talking about me multitasking. You're everywhere yourself. You're on television. You're on podcasts. You're hosting events. You're wearing all the various linen you can find and reaching places. It's beautiful. I love that. More power to you.
Thank you. Does Tiani qualify for the very infamous airport looks? Are we going to be spotting any celebrities in airport looks?
Totally. We're meeting all the wonderful stylists this evening. And gym look, airport look, kitchen look, in-house, out-house, whatever look. I mean, I'm hoping there's a third look in store because we're done with gym now. We moved on from airport and went to gym.
Yeah.
Now I think we're going to go into like some other. What is the third? Pilates look? I don't know.
Sure. Unfortunately, Rishi Kapoor at some point said chautha looks also.
Well, those have always been popular. That was white and dark glasses, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
All right.
You're ready.
I hope nobody dies.
Well, even if they do, you're ready.
Yeah, I'm ready. On this auspicious note, I must say that it's been fabulous talking to you, Karan.
Thank you.